I have some iced tea this week. Clink, 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 clink.
So, do you want to see a magic trick?
So I have this character, and she's holding a flower in her hands, right? But what if I told you these flowers were actually in front of her hands? And what about all these flowers behind her? Nope, they're also in front of her. At least these two in the front are.
What is going on here?
So there are three ways that grease pencil strokes are layered. To start, we'll look at strokes within the same grease pencil object. So this one grease pencil object contains the character's hands and the flowers. So I can select it and press Shift H to hide everything else. And then if I go into Object Data Properties, you can see that I have five layers: the line art of the hands and the fill color of the hands, and the line art and fill of the flowers, and also the sparkle lines around the main flower. So if you scroll down, you find strokes, and if we open that, we get this option for stroke depth order. If I change the default setting and make it 3D location, now the strokes are acting as you might expect, so they lie on top of one another based on which ones are closer to us in 3D space. So this sounds like it would be cool, but it doesn't look that good, does it? That's because the line art was drawn on the same 2D planes as the fills. Now we could go into edit mode, scroll back up to our layers, select the fill layer, and then move them back in space. But it's still not perfect, and it still looks even worse from the back. So although I personally have never used this, I did come up with a scenario where you might want to use this, where it might come in handy, but we'll look at that at the end. And so I like to set the stroke depth order to 2D layers. And so the line art at the top of the list shows on top of everything, and then the hand fills show on top of everything else, and so on down the list. For someone coming from another drawing software, I'm sure this is the mode that will feel the most familiar. You can know exactly what will show up on top of what, and fear not if you draw on the wrong layer. Because Blender's grease pencil is vector-based, all of the strokes exist separately from one another, and so it's very easy to go into edit mode. I recommend using stroke select up here and the lasso select tool if you hold down here and choose select lasso. Then you can just shift select everything that's on the wrong layer and press M to move it either to another layer or to a new layer that you can create and rename. Not to mention the logistics of actually using grease pencil strokes in 3D space. So this piece was colored in using my watercolor brush, and so basically, this means that I used strokes that have a very large radius. But because our work in grease pencil exists in 3D space, these big strokes also exist as giant blobs, meaning that if you choose the stroke depth order of 3D location, you're gonna have a bad time. So there are many reasons you may not want to have all your grease pencil in one object. You may want to give some of the strokes an effect, but not have it impact certain other strokes, or an object constraint. You may want to animate some of them, or just keep your different sections separate. So for this section, I'd like to give a big shout out to Smef for letting me use his blend file as an example. So I'll link to his YouTube and Instagram down below. So his question was why? Why the clipping? Why is stuff showing up in front of other stuff when they're actually behind them in 3D space? So we have three grease pencil objects. We have the character and his bike, and then we have one for the back arm and for the back leg. So the way that grease pencil objects are layered has to do with their object origins. So first, we need to make them visible. So I want to check on the Show Overlays box up here, and I can click the drop-down menu to make sure that the object origins are visible. So now we can see the origin for each object, the yellow, orange dot that appears when you select them. So which grease pencil objects will be layered on top of other ones has to do with which origins are closest to us in 3D space. So the easiest way to work with this would be to select each grease pencil object individually, press Ctrl A, and select Apply All Transforms. So now their origins are all at the 3D cursor, which is at the world origin. And then we can reorder them just by moving their position in 3D space slightly. So we could do this either by selecting an object. I'll do the back leg first. So I can press G to move it. And by holding shift, I can nudge it just a tiny amount. Or we could select it and then press N to open the item transforms. And we could manually add a location value to nudge it just that tiny amount once again. So in most cases, this is what I use, and I think it works really well. But you may run into some trouble if you want to rotate around your grease pencil world. So this is my file for my recent 3D painting. But I've hidden everything except for the grease pencil objects that contain the foliage and the branches. So because which object shows up on top of the other one has to do with which origin is closest to us, this will change as we rotate around it and the origins don't move. One solution could be to keyframe the object. So you animate it, you move the origin just slightly. But for this, we could also try using our poor neglected friend Stroke Depth Order by 3D Location. So I can select the layer with the branches, open up this drop-down menu, and at the bottom, select Copy Layer to Object and move it to my Foliage object. And then I can hide the Branches object. And then if I select the Foliage object, scroll down and change the Stroke Depth Order to 3D Location, we can rotate around the object with no issues. It did change the way that the foliage strokes show up. And if I had planned on using the 3D location, I may have drawn the strokes differently. Figuring stuff out with grease pencil can definitely feel like a puzzle sometimes. And there's no one best way to do something. So I hope that this has been helpful and that it's given you more tools when it comes to tackling the wild beast that is grease pencil. Liking and subscribing would be a big help to this channel. You can find me at all the social medias at Sophie Jantak. Thank you so much for being here, and I will see you very soon. Bye, and cheers!